With the use of a unique dual treadmill, a team of Penn Staters explore altered strides. The objective? Keeping the pace and walking pain-free. That's right now, in motion.
What this treadmill does is it takes the uphill and downhill treadmill in addition to the dual belt force treadmill and allows us to measure the walking forces under each individual foot during uphill and downhill locomotion. We added a special little twist. It also rolls. So you can imagine situations where you're walking and it's an uneven sidewalk and you're kind of tilted in or out. And that's what this also does, which we know nothing about right now. There is, without a doubt, not a treadmill in the world, actually, that has all of the components that this one does.
This one-of-a-kind treadmill is a Penn State original, designed, modified, and built by a team of kinesiology department staff.
We have Denny Ripka, Big D. He's a professional machinist, and it's really not an exaggeration when I say that he has machined every single piece. He's even machined the rollers themselves. So we can incorporate any little detail or any novelty into the device because he has the ability to put those ideas into actual concrete form. Then Randy McCullough, the Terminator, he can actually understand the scientific principles that I'm wanting. I give him a couple research articles, he reads them, and then comes in and figures out how we can actually make that work. Those two put together is really a unique unit that you would never come across this in another place.
Loss of a limb, an injury, pregnancy, and aging are a few conditions that can cause people to favor a side or even alter their gait, making walking both distressing and painful.
I've also tested multiple types of orthopedic patients, so those individuals who do not have an ACL or who have a reconstructed ACL. We've also had people, amputees, visit the lab, both below and above the knee amputees. Any person or group of people that has some sort of asymmetry between the two legs, this can really tell us a lot about the nervous system. Stroke individuals, it's really limitless in terms of applications in the end after we learn some of these basic mechanisms.
The information gathered helps to determine the flaws in a person's natural mechanics, as well as illustrate how a subject's sensory system helps or hinders walking patterns. The data is then provided to physical therapists and other rehabilitation professionals who are helping the individual stay mobile.
The longer that people can stay active and mobile, the more independent their lives are, the less assisted care they need.
For In Motion, I'm Kurt Parker.